Den här sändningen sponsras av Lager 1, Self Storage. Dagens ÖFK TV med Ian Birchnell och fansens frågor till Ian. Lots of fans who wants to make you questions.
That's good. Yeah? Fire away.
Yeah. Will Ravel Morrison have a free role or will be more offense like you used him in the serious game?
Or more what?
Offense.
More offense.
Yeah.
More free.
Yeah.
But a free role is pretty offensive. Well, the times we've used him now, we've used him more as a number 10, so I think that's where he's best, in between the lines, quite high up the pitch, gets to create and into the final third. So, yeah, that's where we that's where we've used him most, and that's probably where I think his strength is.
Mm-hmm. And no thoughts about any other role for him?
Yeah, it depends really on the game. You could use him deeper if there's to get on the ball a little bit more. We tried him out wide against Molde, but we wasn't so happy with that. Didn't get on the ball in the kind of areas that we wanted him to. So, no, I think down the central, anywhere down the central is the best for him.
Mm-hmm. Some questions about training. The training you do with the players, how many percent is adapted to the individual players?
Ooh, really good question. A lot is individual. I think we sit down and go through almost every player on an individual basis before. Of course, everybody has to play collectively, but then each have got their own little programs before. Some do something extra during the session, some do something extra after the session. So it's quite individualized, although, of course, we have to piece it together as a team. But each person kind of has a different load that they have to go through every day. So it's quite an interesting process. For me, anyway.
How are you measuring the player's fit and status? You use any program?
Or? Yeah, well, we use every player's got GPS that we train with, so that gives us an idea on the kind of load that they use. It kind of gives us how much they've run, how fast they've run, how much and where. And then following that, we do a lot of work with, like, the players have got individual questionnaires that they fill out every morning saying how they're feeling, how they've slept, how they've eaten. Yeah, if they have any pain. And so we kind of monitor those things there. And then, of course, Jenny's got good control over most of the kind of parameters for fitness and injury and things like that. So, yeah, it's quite. We try to do as much detail as we can so that we've got the best kind of information that we can base the players' training on.
Mm-hmm. Are you going to have time to see some local football?
Yeah, I watched. I was in the stands for EFK Östersund versus Utterhogdal in the cup the other night. So when, yeah, if I get the opportunity to try and watch one or two games, I always like to watch live football, and if there's some local football, I do. So I was at that game on Tuesday night. So certainly when they're at the arena, I watch them, and if I can get about, I try and watch one or two.
Mm-hmm. When you were a player, were you a good player?
No, I wasn't. I'd like to tell you that I was, but no, yeah, it was.
You can't lie.
No, I can't lie. I got a nice right foot. I could hit a good diagonal pass, but yeah, I wasn't one of the top players. No, but I was. I think I understood the game okay, so maybe that's why I'm a coach.
Mm-hmm. Which player were your idol when you were young?
Paul Gascoigne. Paul Gascoigne was my favourite player growing up.
And why? Then,
because the first World Cup that I ever watched was Italia 90, and then Gascoigne, with him crying in the semi-final, and some of his performances through the tournament was unbelievable. You know, the kind of player he was and personality off the pitch, Gascoigne was absolutely my favourite growing up. And then more recently, probably Zidane. I used to love watching Zidane play, so probably those two, but Gazza was always my favourite.
Mm-hmm. Will you play for FK Cosmos this season?
No, I won't.
Brian is playing there, and Bobo.
Yeah, when I say playing for when I, because I watch Wakey play, okay. But no, I don't think so, and that's not on my agenda. Probably because I don't want to get injured, and I don't think I'm fit enough to play at the moment. So maybe if I get a few training sessions in, I could do Al a favour. But I find it highly unlikely that I'm going to play any football there this year.
When you got the call from Östersund about the job as a coach, what part was it that you felt like, oh, that one I like, that's why I choose Östersund?
A few things, really. I think when I yeah, when I first, you know what, when I first left Viking, which was the last club I was at in Christmas, I spoke to quite a few clubs about jobs, but quite a few didn't feel right. And I said it'd been a difficult year that I'd had in Viking. And then I said, whatever club I take really has to feel like the right kind of place that, embraces my thoughts on football, has a good identity, has a good structure within the club. So all of those things were probably the most important for me. And then when I got the call from here, I obviously had known Graham before and spoken to him, and he had such good things to say about the town and the club. So for me, it was, of course, a really interesting proposition for the way the team plays, the way it's been structured and the way it's been run, I think, was the most interesting for me.
As a coach, are you afraid to get fired?
No, I've been fired before, so then I think they just say once you've been fired once, then you don't care as much because you've had it. So I think it's part of the job that is always like that always comes with results. So, but I think I've feel like you have good belief with the people behind you here and good security. So then I don't use my energy thinking about it, because especially in football's a crazy business. So you focus on the things that you can control the most.
Three or four defenders?
Depends on which three it is. I like to play with both, and it depends on the game, and it depends on which players are available. And you can see in a lot of the games we change between three and four as well. So for me, it depends on the game and the personnel available.
Which player in Allsvenskan is the best? You can't choose one in your own team.
That's a good question.
I think you met them all.
Yeah, I met more or less. There's of course forward that was here that I think is excellent in the midfield for Malmo, and Batanero for Sundsvall is a really nice player to watch, so maybe one of those two.
Do you know the ÖFK song Rött och Svart Pumpar Hjärtat?
Yeah, I do, because we sang it. Where did we sing it? We sing it at one of the, I think we sang it on the when we did that Star for Life concert. So then we had a lot of practices upstairs singing the song. I know the song. I'm not going to sing it for you now. But I definitely know the song. That's for sure.
What do you eat to breakfast?
Me? Oh, we have the best breakfast.
Alan
and Jude's breakfast is absolutely top class.
And what's
eating? Normally porridge and fruit and a little bit of honey. Okay. But sometimes eggs and scrambled eggs as well. Or maybe all of it. Depends how hungry I am.
And beans?
Yeah, sometimes beans, yeah, but...
Typical English.
Yeah, but we love baked beans, but I try not to eat them every day.
Okay.
Yeah.
Three long shots make the three goals against Falkenberg. Have you have a special practice on that or what?
No, we haven't, but we do work on finishing, of course. And like at half time, we said that the opportunity was there to take some shots and we wanted them to do it. So I was glad that they did it. But and we've said sometimes for a team like us that wants to play and create opportunities, it's really important that teams that just put park the bus sometimes, it's good for us to be able to have that threat of hitting a long shot, because then teams come out to press to stop it, and then you can play through them as well. So yeah, it's something that we've discussed, but of course it depends on the quality of player, and the three hits that we had were fantastic, so that was good.
Thank you very much, and tack så hemskt mycket för alla era frågor som ni skickade in. Ian har svarat på en hel del av de här frågorna i alla fall. Här är ÖFK TV.